Hey guys, I have a glimpse into the future for you. What you see right here next to me is a demo vehicle. It happens to be a VW ID3, but it's a steer-by-wire demonstrator, which means there is no physical connection between the front tires and the steering wheel. So let me get in, let me learn a little bit more about this technology, and I think you'll be seeing a lot more of these vehicles on the road. It's not just about the Cybertruck anymore. There'll be more systems like this.
Tobias?
Yes.
Andre.
Hi, nice to meet you.
So this is a VW ID3, which is a demonstration vehicle, right?
Yeah, exactly.
A prototype.
Yeah. Compact car with our steer-by-wire system. So the handrail is completely
physically disconnected.
Disconnected,
right?
From the front axle. No mechanical connection, no mechanical fallback at all. And yeah, we try to implement.
Can get going?
Of course.
There's a big truck blocking us, but that's okay, right?
Yeah, we can go around. So here we have the concept validation version in, and we try to replicate the normal driving behavior of the ID3. Mm-hmm. Here, then the normal driver will not recognize that there is no mechanical connection.
So, couple questions, right? Mm-hmm. So initially, I just get in the car and I can feel there's quite a bit of assist, mm-hmm. right? The steering is a little bit light. Can you change that as well?
Of course, it's fully parameterable, and that's the reason why we call it software defined, because we can arrange every parameter, so we can replicate several brands. So that the DNA of a BMW, of a VW, of any kind of brand can be replicated.
Yeah, and you could change that, you know, there could be different modes, right, as you're driving.
Sure. And so this is the demonstrator for the steer feel, and we have another car for different modes so that we can change the ratio. And this is, of course,
dynamically.
Dynamically.
Okay.
In certain ranges, of course. And we have a special mode, this go-kart mode, to enable the yoke steering wheel that you only have to steer 180 degrees for the full stroke on the front axle.
But this feels kind of normal, right? This is a compact car, kind of like a Golf, you know,
yeah,
it's kind of
exactly.
the same size.
Exactly.
It's an ID3.
Exactly.
And all electric.
We try to get exactly this feedback. It's driving like a normal car, so not to disturb the driver or to surprise the driver.
Uh-huh.
With a different or synthetic steer feel. And
can we get on the longer area?
Yeah, of
course. How do I go there?
We can leave the dynamic area like this on this way.
Sharp turn.
Sharp turn.
Okay.
To the right.
So
it's coming. And then up to 80 kph, so this is the maximum.
Okay. And we can go around this little loop.
Yeah.
So I think one question that people usually have when you talk about steer-by-wire is redundancy or safety. Can you talk a little bit about this?
Sure. So we have a certain redundancy, not via the mechanical fallback, but fully redundant board net and power supply. To the right, please, on the right.
Around the water?
Yeah, please. So it's a really fail operational system here, so if a failure occurs, the system will still be alive and will be steerable.
So how does that work? I mean, is there a different like electric motors or different circuits, or how does that work?
Doubled. Everything is doubled and diverse, so that we can exclude certain failures or common cause failures through this diversity and through the doubling of the board net and doubling power supply. The motors are doubled, so if one lane fails, the other will take over.
I gotcha. And there will be some messaging, right, if something is happening?
Sure. It depends on the failure severity, of course. So
yeah.
the different kind of failures, severities, and this will be indicated.
And what about the voltage? What kind of a system is this using?
It's 12 volt. Okay. It's derived from the EPS.
Okay.
So we stayed in the 12 volt.
Well, I gotta tell you, first of all, I did notice the steering was very easy. So this is a city car and it's really easy to steer. I had no concerns. On the higher speed track, on the oval, also was very stable. I'm quite pleased. I did not notice any differences. If somebody didn't tell me this was steer by wire or not steer by wire, I don't think I would have known a difference. So this is pretty cool. But we don't know exactly when technology like this will be in your next car. So we'll have to wait and see. Yes, the Cybertruck already uses a more advanced and more complicated version of the system because the Cybertruck has quad steer, four-wheel steering. But this doesn't, so we'll have to wait and see. I'll see you next time. Thanks for joining me.